Here we are. Hello, everyone, and welcome to another night of Star Wars Squadrons. Tonight, we have Nimue Sirens versus Cat on S-List. So let me get the predictions going. Hydrate! Okay, I'll do that after I do predictions. Cat versus Nimue Siren. Not a third option. Start. Okay. Get your predictions in. I will hydrate real quick. So. Just waiting for a couple more to join the lobby, and we will be underway. Let them know that I'm ready and good to go. This should be a really interesting game tonight. Both Nimue and Cat like to err on the side of PK. S-List is really large though, so we'll see how that works. If people will be able to, you know, the travel time will be a factor or not with getting kills. And Nimue usually running the B-Wing, travel time is definitely going to affect the B-Wing's effectability since it is extremely slow. But we'll see how Nimue works with that. Yay, Hydrate! And yes, we have people for both Cat and Nimue. Although it looks like a bunch of people are putting their money on Cat over Nimue for the predictions. Any Nimue lovers in chat? Hype indeed! Just waiting on one more person. There's the last person. They've got the faction set. They're just waiting for the okay, and we will be right there in the lobby. Nope, no new healers here. Oh my gosh, babe. And yes, if you win your predictions, you too will have the fish points to use the sound alerts, as Fame is demonstrating. Lots of good ones there. Alright, Cat's ready, waiting for Nimue to ready up. You're trying to drum up more action in the fish points. You can put a hat on the cat, too.
Emotional, damn it!
Looks like they've got the lobby started, so we'll head on over that way. So once again, we have Cavern Angel's Thunder on Empire for the first game. Then we opted for NR. We've got Suchi, Time Bomb, Revenite, Pseudo, and Biker on Empire. Time Bomb fixing his gloves. Those gloves always have a tough time fitting right. It's unfortunate that the Empire can't afford proper gloves. Over here, we got JC flexing. We've got Kitster, Sidestack, Professor Autumn, and Ska along with them. You want to clarify from your earlier statement you voted for Nimue. Aw, yeah. Got some Nimue love in the chat. Though they're not very animated tonight. Probably trying to figure out their strat. Oh, there goes Autumn. Flexing on everybody. Let's see if Cat are a little more active. They're all just kind of standing there. Cat also with... Oh, there they go! And Revanite said no, because he's a sour sport. Oh, we miss Kitster flexing. Rip. He should do it when we're watching him next time. Also, I forgot to mention that cat was pretty, they had a really nice thing going on with their outfits, all matching, so you'll love to see it. So coming out of the MC-75, we've got Niwi Siren in their typical BA setup. Ska in the B-Wing with Torps. Autumn in the A-Wing with Rockets. JC standard support. Side stack. And Kitster in standard bombers. On Empire side, we have Suchi in standard defender. Time Bomb, standard farm. Revanite, standard defender. Pseudo in the pancake. And Biker in standard farm. Biker looking at a pack. Lining it up probably for goal. He gets a little roasted. I think that was that from Autumn or was that from the Nebulon? Because he was pretty close there too. Either way, Autumn is chasing him around. And Niwi very quickly took that open. Time Bomb under pressure as well. But not anymore. Looks like he was left alone. Side stack getting wrecked. Probably by Biker, but he's okay for now. Ska looks like he got dunked. He's got no shields and no hull. JC gets him a resupply though. Looks like might be Suchi on him. Suchi and Pseudo trying to make sure that Ska doesn't get any torps off. That's in, down Ska goes. That's the only drawback about running a torp B-Wing, because it's very easy to prevent damage coming in. Meanwhile, Autumn catches Biker sleeping, manages to nab a kill. The morale's at half, and Niwi hasn't really done too much damage on Delta yet. Side stack is working on it, and I suspect Kister is too, though Kister's low on oxes will need a resup for farm. Looks like Time Bomb went down, so Autumn is trying to stall the farm a bit, give them more time to get damage in. It looks like Suchi looking at the Corvette. Corvette almost flips. Like this and like a couple AI should do the trick, and they should be able to stop the damage before Niwi gets an oop. As long as that last AI, there it goes. So Niwi didn't manage to get a nuke on their first attack. They got the cruiser a little below half. So not too bad, but without Ska being in, that kinda really hurt their damage. Meanwhile, Autumn goes down. Kitster trying to farm. Looks like, is that an AI that was chasing Pseudo? Or was that an actual player? I think that might have been an AI, because it kind of like stopped on that dish. Pseudo's okay though, for now. Trying to get the marks in. Looks like he got in a little late. The shields literally just went down, and morale is at half. Side stack must have died. JC must have flown back to get more resupplies. Biker is PKing Autumn instead of doing damage when he's on offense. Now he's doing damage. Suchi also getting damage in. Time Bomb also doing damage. They've got the Nebulon about the same health as Niwi did. So good job on Niwi for getting that flip pretty quickly. Pseudo is resupplying. They were almost dead, but the flip prevents them from healing completely. Autumn looking at Biker, trying to get another pick to slow down the morale gain. Is Ska going to get in? Looks like Ska does get in. He launches both torps. Looks like they got Delta Oopable. I wonder if Ska got it lower with the torps while they were on defense. I'll have to... If they don't get this Oopable, I'll have to see if that's what he does. He's lining up his torp runs. Doesn't stay long enough to do so. Is any of them attacking him? No, we got Suchi taking the Raider. Raider goes down. Bravo, still not quite oopable. Alpha is time bomb low. Trying to farm still. Where's Pseudo? Pseudo got a resupply to Biker. Now they're looking at time bomb. Will they get the resupply to him in time? Or, yeah, it looks like it. Yeah. I was like, is Autumn gonna be munching on time bomb? But no. Looks like Autumn has Revenite chasing her. Probably trying to keep her off the rest of the group. Meanwhile, Niwi does manage to get a double out of phase before Cat can flip. Now, they could technically go through if they wanted and try to get a gen since the morale's kind of stalled, but it's starting to come in now. How's the farm? Bugs isn't farming. Bugs is BKing. That's probably why the morale stalled, because Biker Bugs is not BKing. Time Bomb is also not BKing, or is farming. I guess they're trying to get picks on the Ys. Which is a good idea, though. JC is still on the field, so he's keeping them alive. Oh, now they're looking at Ska and the B-Wing, since Ska is pretty low. Revenite trying taking Ska down to 5. Ska goes down. Side stack also went down, so that's 2 dead for Niwi. Can't have a full cruiser to go. So the farm is kind of slow, and I'm not quite sure what Ska did much on defense, but we'll find out once he respawns. Biker's in, getting damage done. Shields are down, morale's just starting to come in. The Niwi is taking the, Ska actually swapped to an X-Wing now. Which he tends to do when he's prepping for, ISD. Wow, Pseudo just got destroyed. Autumn took a big hit though in the process, looking at Revenite. Revenite appears to be trying to get damage in, since he knows that they don't have much morale left. Charlie's almost oopable. If they push it, they can probably do that even without the marks. But Revenite looks like he is getting on Ska to try and stop the, well, he was. Not anymore. He's taking the oop. I would have just stayed on Ska because Ska is gonna go in for a dunk to get the shields. He's already over the ISD. Where's JC? JC's going for a shield dunk. Got it. Is Ska getting the other one? Ska's under pressure. Gets dunked. He's very low. Trying to get his shields back up, but he cannot make a run on the gens. Is JC going to take care of it for him? Looks like he's trying. Oh, Ska got dunked again. Bounces off the shield gen. JC struggling to... Okay, there. The gens finally went down. And somehow, they still have a lot of morale, even after all that time was taken to get the gens down. Revenite looking at the Raider. Biker is pretty low. Honestly, I'd put the defenders on defense duty instead of killing the raider. A bomber can do that much faster than they can. And you kinda wanna kill the players that are trying to do damage so you can mitigate as much as possible. Time bomb went down. Niwi's got the ISD to 34. Kitster trying to dock in the ISD doesn't work. He needs oxes though. He got a little desperate there. There's two weak points underneath. They're not taking them. Okay, so Sight Stag went down. The phase flips. Niwi has it down to three, and there it goes. And game one goes to Niwi Siren. So GG's to Siren. Good effort to Cat. Let's take a look at the scoreboard. Kitster, 36 AI, 1 kill, 62,000 cap ship. Side stack, 12 AI, 63,000 cap ship. Ska, no kills, but 81,000 cap ship damage. Autumn with 3 kills, 11,000 cap ship damage. Probably went after some weak points there. Suchi, 3 kills, 59,000 cap ship. Revenite, 2 kills, 23,000 cap ship. Biker, 2 kills, 46,000 cap ship, 18 AI, time bomb, 26 AI, 52,000 cap ship damage. And once again, well done to both teams. So let's fix the predictions. Niwi won game one. So congratulations to those who voted for Niwi. Now we'll do Niwi Siren versus Cat. Game two. Predictions started. Go for it. So now, Niwi will be playing Empire. We'll see when they get the lobby set up. So yeah, I think what Cat should have done for that last defense, they should have stayed on Scott. Like, I mean, they did keep Scott out, but I feel like the two defenders, instead of taking the raider, they should have stayed PKing to try to mitigate as much damage as possible, because the bombers can take the raider much faster than they can, and if you don't pressure them, then they're getting free damage in on your ISD, which makes it a lot easier to kill. But GG's anyways, we'll see how they adjust. They don't have a B wing or an A wing to deal with on with Siren on Empire. However, they do tend to run the Interceptor. Ska likes to play a little more on the OBJ side with the Interceptor. Yo, Sudo with the raid. Thank you so much. Let's go. Thank you, Sudo. All right, they got the lobby up. Okay, match under Barry. And let's see. Okay, I'm heading in. Let them know that I'm ready. And then once everybody else jumps into the lobby, we'll hopefully get game two rolling. How do you have 15K? He probably like AFKs. Though he tends to spend them on the sound alert, so that's why his fish count is so low. All right, everybody, just about in the lobby. Everybody's in the lobby. Still waiting on the ready ups. Oh, I need to fix the, did I fix the overlay? Nah, let's do that real quick before the lobby starts. Cat on NR. And Niwi Siren on Empire. Niwi has 1 point. Niwi took game one. And the lobby's starting, so let's head on over there for game number two. So once again, we've got Niwi Siren on Empire, Professor Autumn fixing her gloves. They never fit quite right. It looks like they've got a sub in for Siren. They've got Raven, who normally plays for Night Sisters Crone. Or not Night Sisters, Night Witch's Crone. Subbing in for Niwi tonight on Empire side. Looks like Ska is missing, so maybe Ska had to go early. There goes the synchronized glove flexing. You'll love to see it. Let's check out in our side. I do like that helmet that Cat uses for NR, that wood helmet. Looks so pretty nice. And they've got matching flight suits. Though a couple of them are wearing different gloves, or at least one of them is. Soulhawk with the mismatched gloves. Minus points for that. Rip Ska. We got Time Bomb and Revenite flexing and playing the sax. They're all hyped up and ready. They're feeling confident as they head back out on Aeselus for game number two. No B-Wing on Empire equals no Ska. Yeah, it's you, Fly Defender. And here we go, coming out of the MC-75, we have Cavern Angels Thunder, aka Cat, Time Bomb, Standard Farm, Revenite, Standard Flex, Soulhawk in the support this time, Biker, Standard Farm, and Suchi, Cock Flex. We've got Revenite, Standard Defender, Kitster, Standard Farm, Autumn in her double Ion TIE Fighter, JC, Standard Pancake, and Slack, Standard Farmer, who is starting to take some pressure. I think he was getting shot by... Oh, Biker died already. That's unfortunate. Slack is half dead, but not under pressure, I don't think. They flipped real quick, though. Probably got their packs and that one kill on Biker. Took the open. So they are now in. Is JC in? Yep, JC's in. I don't think he had the marks out though because... Yeah, he just put the marks out. Probably had to wait since the open happened rather quickly. But the shields are down and now Empire's starting to get damage in on the Nebulon. Revenite happens to go down during that. And though Cat's morale is growing, Niwi has less than a half bar of morale to get going. Autumn needs a torp for that raider. Looks like they'll get this Ooper Bowl. Are they burning the raider? No, they're trying to kill JC. Time Bomb still farming. Suchi looking at JC as well. There goes a conk. It misses. But it's time for Cat to go on offense since the phase flipped and they need to get some damage in before they lose all their morale. Biker taking a little roundabout way to get to the cruiser. Trying to be sneaky. I imagine did Soulhawk get the marks out? They just went out. Time Bomb looking a little hurt. Soulhawk gets the Marie Supply. Kitster went down. Autumn is looking at PK. Blinding Biker up. I think. Oh, Autumn used Seekers to kill, I guess, the Maltese. JC looking hurt. Is he gonna go down? He's using the Force to fly. He's chaffing the cruiser, trying to keep it alive as much as possible. Revenite looking at JC. Now getting some damage in. They are strong side, so they should get the Super Bowl. Assuming that Niwi... Nah, it doesn't look like Niwi is letting it stay up. Okay, so they can take this. It's at 8, 7, 6. They shoot down Marie Supply. Let's see, JC's not going in. JC is pretty hurt and out of everything. Slax is heading in. Out of Golos, has two multis. Shields are down on the Nebulon though. So both Cat and Niwi managed to get their oops on the first offense. Pretty well done. Autumn going in, doing damage. Trying to push this as quickly as possible. Kitster, hurt, trying not to die. Down to 22. I saw that resup go out, but it doesn't look like it hit. There we go. Kidster's okay for now. Raven is out of everything. Needs a resup. Might be heading back. No, she's turning back around. I can't tell what. Okay, yeah, they got this. It's well, it's at 4. And down it goes. So, Raven did pick up that resupply. Looking at Revenite. Fires an ion from very far away. Does not land. Meanwhile, Suchi is in trying to get the shields down on the cruiser. It is marked. Time Bomb. Also, oh, Time Bomb's completely dry on everything. So that's gonna make stripping it kind of annoying. Where's Soulhawk? Soulhawk is completely out of recepts. That's no bueno! Biker has one of each ox left, and they will soon be on defense. This offense isn't lasting too long for Cat. Suchi is out of conks. What's Revenite looking like? Revenite still has torps. Is not firing them though. How far did they get it? Is anybody still looking at it? Oh, it's not even smoking. They didn't get it far enough. So in goes Niwi on the okay, JC's not going in. JC's getting more resups. Slax is going in on the MC to kill a gen. Takes a little scrape. The gen's at 6. Slax is completely out of oxes. And low on health. Oh, caught in the tractor beam. Takes a bonk to get out of it. Very low. Oh, Autumn went down. JC also died, so Slax is not getting a resupply. Does any of... No, Revenite's looking at the Raider. Suchi also looking at the Raider. Slax still dies. And Raven also died. That's pretty not great for Niwi. They got one gent down at least. I didn't see if they got the other one. But they all kind of went in and died. Kitster farming at half hole. JC needs to get out there to save him. He's looking at him. Gets the resup out. So now, that was a pretty good defense for Cat. Now they're on the ISD with a full morale bar. Revenite gets dunked while he's going for a gen run. If you got people following you, don't go for a gen. Soulhawk gets the dunk on one of the gents. Tsuchi must have got the other. And now they are heading down to probably look at power. Tractor beam went down. Looks like time bomb. Yeah, time bomb is working. The turret's underneath. They are fixing to oop this. The raider goes down. They still got about a quarter morale left. Biker is in trouble. Time bomb looks like he got dunked. He's at the back. Revanite moving back in, trying to get power. Also helping to strip. Alright, so the Star Destroyer is at 52 when the phase flips. They can still do this. I think it's pretty well stripped. So they should be able to oop this. However, everybody's dying. All of Cat are like dying for whatever reason. Revanite's the only one in. He's gonna die too. That's a full team wipe on the ISD, which is highly unfortunate for Cat, because that's probably GG's, as Niwi has the shields down and are cranking damage on the MC-75. Pretty uncontested. JC going for power. Power goes down. Yeah, power goes down. Autumn is no longer in a double eye on TIE Fighter, which kinda works. Yeah, this MC is super low, so are they even trying to go back? What's going on? Yeah, they're trying to oop it, but it's too little too late as the MC-75 goes down. And Night Witch's Siren takes the 2-0 victory over Cavern Angel's Thunder. So GG's and congrats. Taking a look at the scoreboard, Revanite 2 kills, 3 deaths, 59,000 cap ship. Tsuchi 1 kill, 58,000 cap ship. Time Bomb with 41 AI, 36,000 cap ship. Biker with 20 AI, 37,000 cap ship. We got Slacks with 116,000 damage, 22 AI. Kitster 43 AI, 100,000 cap ship. And we got 2 kills on Autumn and Raven. Autumn with 54,000 cap ship, Raven with 15,000 cap ship. So once again, congratulations to Niwi Siren for the 2-0 dub over Cavern Angel's Thunder. Good work, both teams. Better luck next time, Cat. You tried your best. But alas, it was not meant to be tonight. So, let's see. I'm going to get ready to cut the stream, but I want to see if there's any additional games. There was a game earlier, like last minute earlier today, that was BSS versus Krone. And Krone took the 2-0 win against BSS, though that last game, I managed to catch the last game. It was really close. Like, BSS had DISD down to 5 when the MC-75 dropped, so that was a very tight game for them. They were so close, but they didn't quite manage to get it. But that's good that they're getting better. You'll love to see it. I don't see any more games. Well, there's GMT versus Cab in 2 days, so there's that to look forward to. Other than that, I don't see anything else on the calendar. But, oh, they want to do interviews? Sure, let's do interviews. Let me jump into the interview channel. And then it looks like we will get some Niwi coming up in here shortly for some interviews. The pressure of watching you all win and then playing isn't great. Aww. Yes, GG's to everyone. Cat did make them work for
Do it.
Hey, Berry Sacks, and hello,
hello,
Professor Autumn.
Hello.
And Raven.
Hello.
A special sub for tonight.
Yeah. Rich,
and we got Kister jumping in too. Everybody's here. Well, once again, congratulations for your 2-0 victory over Cat.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Very well played. So,
yeah, it was exciting. And I just want to say, first of all, just great game to Cat, and also to Raven, who was making her sort of a debut on Siren. She's been practicing with us a lot lately, and so getting to have her play a game with us and seeing the result of all of that practice and all of that stuff, it was just awesome.
It
and I'm just
seems like something's paid off.
Yeah.
Yes.
I thought you guys thank for it.
Practice makes perfect, as the saying goes.
Exactly.
But also great games to Cat. We were kind of worried in both games for most of it. It was close. So just really well played by them too.
Yeah, they made you work for it, most definitely. So GG's to them. I was a little surprised that Scott wasn't running the interceptor. Did he have to leave early?
He has been traveling, so.
Oh.
Get him a break if possible.
Fair enough.
But nobody else can fly a B-Wing, so what are you going to do?
Nobody else can fly a B-Wing. I mean, technically you could. It may not happen the same way that Scott flies a B-Wing, but still, it was good job tonight, and Raven did a fine job taking his spot in the Defender tonight.
Thank you.
Yep. So, I know you guys usually do the BA. But you usually run the interceptor on Empire, so I guess you decided to just let Raven fly a Defender since that's what she usually flies, or?
Yeah, we just kind of have to work around it a little bit.
That's fair.
But yeah, we've flown with TIE Defender before, you know.
That's
pairing,
true.
So we know it can work, but yeah. Anyway, Barry, you were saying.
It was just a slight switch of roles, right? So, kind of, rather than having Ska really pumping out damage in the Interceptor, then we have Autumn pump out a little more damage in the TIE Fighter while Raven's doing a little more killing.
So. Yeah, and I'm pretty sure that threw Cat for a loop, because I know they were probably expecting the Interceptor coming out with Ska.
Yeah, but probably.
They still worked pretty well at what they were trying. They almost got the ISD low, though they kind of, that unfortunate team wipe at the end kind of prevented that from happening, but
yeah their attack was really terrifying. Even though we managed to completely delete one of their X-wings, they still got the shields down on time and were doing a lot of damage quickly. It just, like you said, that attack just stalled out with the end of the phase, and then we were able to take it to the house, as they say in the real sports.
Yeah. And they did manage to
real sport.
Imagine playing a real sport.
But anyway, yes.
Yeah. Well, if y'all don't have anything else, I don't want to keep you too long, because I know it might be a little late for some of you.
Well, thank you, Lauren, for casting. We really appreciate it.
Not a problem.
Yeah, 3
a.m. is not a lot late. It's fine.
3 a.m. is a good list. Go get some
thank
sleep.
Thank you,
Yeah, no problem. And once right, again,
night,
well
Lauren.
Done, guys. Yes.
Yeah, and GG Cat, of course. Like, always good games.
Yes.
It was terrifying watching them just absolutely try and murder my teammates on NR and then having to come in the second game not knowing. So, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Big respect towards Kat.
Yeah, you'll love to see it.
All right. Well, yep. Take care.
Yep. Take care, everybody.
See you later.
All right, I'll see if Kat wants to do interviews. We'll give them like a couple minutes or so to reply. Oh, did I do the predictions? I don't think I gave everybody there. Well, a lot of people put a ton of money on Niwi Siren. Good lord.
Hey.
Time bomb.
Hey. We just go back and forth for the 7 minutes.
Well, you played well, even though you didn't manage to eke out a win this time.
But no, GG's we were. Either way. Yeah, there's some disappointment amongst the team. I feel like I'm happy with the way we played, especially with losing the openings. Yeah. You know, I felt like we really fought back in both of those games, despite a lot of like being behind, kind of like we did close the gap. I felt like, especially in the NR game.
Yeah, especially on the, like, I was kind of, I saw you guys stripping the underside. I was like, oh, they're going to oop this when they flip. But unfortunately, the team wipe happened. And that was devastating.
There was a lot of strip. I think there was quite a bit of question about how stripped it was underneath. When I got back in, though, I was just sitting under the hangar when the shields were back up. So it was pretty good underneath. Yeah. They did the draw. Bugs was in there getting it done. I took like a tractor beam out or something, and then I got under pressure and like I died pretty unfortunately, pretty fast. If I feel like maybe if I was in there a bit longer too stripping, it would have been a little more secure. And
it did look like it was pretty well stripped by the time you all died. So I think maybe like one or two turrets were still up.
Yeah, I think it was that close. And if we could have been in, if we hadn't wiped, maybe, you know, a lot of what ifs, but I think it was really just, we needed a near perfect ISD attack at the end there. We just didn't quite manage it. They threw a monkey wrench in it and we weren't able to recover. Yeah. But I think overall I'm happy with that. The Empire game, I was mad because I just like my Golo like locked but didn't fire or something, or I boosted past it at the wrong.
No.
You know, I do have a tendency to anticipate my Golos a fair bit. So I may have just like, you know, just done that like I normally do on S-List. And so I didn't get mine off. And then Bugs thinks that his Golo was probably seekered by Autumn.
Yeah,
so that's what we think happened there. So it just, they got ahead of us. We were able to get, is that one? No, that was the slow. So we had a slow first defense. We were able to get some good attacks to catch up. Some good attacks. Some good attacks, you know. We were getting in there and attack. We got some attacks in. I think that helped us catch up. But we were still, again, like, we were just behind. We just couldn't flip it fast. So that was it. The first defense was slow because I took, I think, a death in that defense. And then the last defense on the MC, Bugs was under pressure, and then Kitster turned on me. And as soon as I went down, we just had no more farm, and that kill was the deficit, basically. We could have, you know, maybe defended an ISD from 30 or something and done an attack on the MC. This is the alternative situation if I didn't die. But, you know, we were a little bit behind in that and just couldn't catch up.
It was unfortunate, but you all still played really well.
Yeah, like I said, I feel like, so there's some disappointment amongst the team, but my overall feeling is that we are continuing to improve, especially a game like that where we expect to win openings, but we expect a better showing than that for an opening. So we really didn't do what we kind of feel like gets us into games, and we were still able to be in those games. And the first game too, got it, like Rev and Tsuji played so well. They got 3-2 kills. They didn't die. They were getting the damage. Like me and Bugs, we feel like we definitely dropped the ball into that. We just didn't execute on the farm on Essilis like we should. And we think that was probably the big difference. The deaths were, like I just mentioned, my two deaths were crucial on both of those. So I was hyped we got back into them, but definitely, like it was the counter farm pressure definitely got us on Essilis there. And great play from our flex though. Shout out to them, big time. Rev and Tsuji killing it.
Yeah, it happens sometimes, and I personally am very well aware of how sad things can be when you never win the open. rip opens. But yeah, still, really good job today. And I don't want to keep you too long because you probably got other stuff to do.
Oh, well, thank you, Lauren. Thank you for casting. I can't wait to go watch back your cast later. Check it out.
Yep. Enjoy yourselves and have a good night.
You too. Take care.
Thanks. All right, everybody. We are done for the evening. And once again, I think there's another game in a couple days. It was GMT versus Cab, Cavern Angels Blue. So I'm not sure if who will be casting that yet, but look for the announcement in the SEL channel. But until then, everybody have a good evening, good morning, afternoon, wherever you are in the world, and I will see you all later. Take care and have a good evening.